Hello and welcome to our grand reveal of the Grace Marie Fitzpatrick Subscription Outfit of the Month, powered by Virtual Doll Convention. We are getting close to St. Patrick's Day, and nothing gets me in the mood more than a Shamrock Shimmer dress, because that is what is happening in your adventure box this month. You guys, this outfit is so wonderful. The moment I saw it, we are throwing back to our wonderful Princess of Wales. The moment I saw this outfit on her, she first wore it in 2020 when she was in Ireland, and then she wore it again for her portrait at the National Portrait Gallery. And we are calling this Shamrock Shimmer. And it is an homage to a dress that was made by a small company called The Vampire's Wife. And the Princess of Wales, Catherine, has worn outfits from this brand a couple of time. So as we look at the photos, I am going to read our letter of the month, and we are going to hear all about it and hear about the jewelry and the shoes. Happy March. We are overjoyed to introduce the Dream Closet Box for March, specially curated for the Grace Marie Fitzpatrick subscription. This month, we're celebrating an exquisite emerald theme that is sure to enchant you. Our highlight is an emerald-colored masterpiece directly inspired by the stunning midi dress that the princess wore during her visit to Ireland in March 2020. Vogue hailed it as a pivotal moment in royal fashion, praising its blend of demure charm and bold style. This dress draws from the early 20th century elegance of the Gibson Girl silhouettes crafted by the Vampire's Wife, featuring a shimmering metallic silk blend chiffon adorned with puffed sleeves, ruffled trims, cascading down into a beautifully draped skirt. The allure of this green metallic dress was immortalized yet again in an official portrait for the National Portrait Gallery by Jamie Corrith, unveiled in June 2022, earning its place as Vogue's Dress of the Decade. To complement this dazzling attire, your box includes satin Manolo Blahnik pumps in matching green, mirroring those that Catherine wore in the portrait. And paying homage to royal tradition, we've added a piece of timeless elegance for your Grace Marie Fitzpatrick doll, a replica of Princess Diana's iconic three-stranded pearl bracelet. We've filled your box with more than just fun. Expect delightful decorations, scrumptious cookies, and endless fun. We hope this Dream Closet Box brings you joy and inspiration throughout the enchanting month of March. Wishing you a fashionable month ahead. In love and dolls, Rachel, Diana, and the VDC crew. I just love this. I hope you do too. And I always truly adore when we can pay homage to the Princess of Wales. Of course, she recently had surgery and she is home recovering and expected to return to her royal duties after April, after Easter. And we are very excited for her return. So what we're going to do now is dive into the box and see all the wonderful things that you are going to receive. So before we dive straight into the box, I want to just talk about this dress real quick. I love how it photographs. I love how it looks. When we received it, I knew by the shimmering fabric it was just going to be perfect for our Grace Marie Fitzpatrick, but when I saw it on her and when I see it across the room, it catches my eye. We have had this in our shop for several months, and every time I pass by, it makes me happy and joyful. And I think that's one of the most beautiful things that can happen from our subscriptions and what we do. One of the things that I have been treating myself to with our subscriptions is I have been enjoying the subscriptions with you. So I have my Grace doll at home and she wears her outfit of the month. Same with Elowen. They both wear their outfits of the month for the month. So I get to enjoy it and join in the adventure. And just every time I walk in the room and I see the beautiful doll in her outfit, it's really a beautiful experience. So this dress just goes on so seamlessly and beautifully and cascades down into those wonderful ruffles. But again, the metallic fabric is wonderful. The shoes are beautiful. They match perfectly, and we don't have very many. We put out our first pair of green shoes for Grace, I think around 2020, and we haven't really put out a lot more green shoes for her. So these are gonna go so well in your closet and with all kinds of other things. Of course, the Manolo Blahnik style right here is just so perfect, and it's just so classic. But what I'm really excited about, oh, and one thing we didn't talk about right in the beginning is that Grace also comes with, she has two pieces of jewelry. She has the wonderful bracelet that is a replica from her mother-in-law's personal collection. She owns this piece. William gave it to her, but I love this. And there are many pictures on the internet of Princess Diana wearing this bracelet that the princess is also wearing in the portrait in the National Portrait Gallery. And then we are also including a beautiful pair of gold and green earrings for you. So you are receiving two pieces of jewelry. You can mix and match this jewelry and of course wear it on all of your other dolls. So you are receiving the dress, the shoes, the bracelet, and the earrings, plus all of the other wonderful things that are in the box. So I'm really proud that we could do this. Christopher accessorized this dress with the bow that we sent out in a lot of the skating outfits in December. So if you have this bow, put it on your doll because I think it looks so, so beautiful. You could also, for Christmas, accessorize with a red bow. How beautiful will this be for the holidays? This is a very classic dress that is going to go down in your archive and in your fashion boutique for, in your own home that you are just going to always love. So we are very, very pleased with this, and I hope you are too. The box is wonderful. Our wonderful Diana Vining, our creative art director over at Club Grace, did a beautiful job with it. I'm going to pull it up here. And first, we're going to see this Shamrock Shimmer. So this is our paper doll. It features our Grace doll with her. I love, Diana did some research here and she came up with beautiful iconography for Ireland and for St. Patrick's Day. You can see a castle down there. There's even a 17th century wooden doll down there, maybe 18th century. In front of the castle. It looks really, really cute. So she did a great job with the paper doll. And we're going to read a little bit of the story because in Grace's adventure, she goes into she wears her beautiful Shamrock Shimmer dress to a wonderful party at an Irish castle. Dia Huach. That's the Irish hello greeting that I quickly learned when I went to a luxurious dinner in a castle in Ireland on St. Patrick's Day. It was amazing to see how the rich heritage of the castle seamlessly blended with exquisite cuisine and wonderful entertainment. The castle's interior was adorned with beautiful tapestries, grand chandeliers, and glistening marble floors. For this special event, I chose a breathtakingly beautiful green dress that mirrors the hue of the lush countryside. The deep emerald fabric almost seems iridescent, and whenever I wear it, it makes me feel like a true Irish princess. To add to this elegant style, I slipped on a pair of matching shimmering green emerald shoes with an ornate silver buckle in the front that seemed to sparkle with every step I took. Delicately draped around my wrist was a three-strand pearl bracelet, with each pearl glistening under the soft castle lights. These jewels mirrored the beauty of the castle itself, and I felt the excitement bubbling up inside of me as I melted into the realm of fairy tales. I'm going to let you read the rest of the story when you receive your box. There's two more paragraphs, but it was written by Diana Vining, and she did such a wonderful job with our story. One of the things that I love about Diana's stories is that it feels like I'm actually stepping into the box, that I'm wearing the garment, that I am Grace, and I'm in this beautiful castle, and I can just imagine what it would feel to be in a beautiful, glistening dress in Ireland in a castle having a luxurious dinner with flowing food and wonderful drinks and bubbly and friends, and it's warm and it's beautiful. And I've never been to Ireland. I would love to go someday, but the countryside of Ireland is just so lush and green and beautiful. And if you've been, please let me know in the comments. It's definitely on my bucket list to go someday because it, from the photos and videos I've seen, it looks like one of the most beautiful places in the entire world to visit. So that is very exciting. So Diana also did a wonderful printable right here. It has some of Grace's mementos from Ireland. So on this printable, you're going to see some of the wonderful things that Grace picked up. And also, there is a portrait of Catherine wearing her dress with Prince William in the National Portrait Gallery. So this was unveiled in 2022. And again, when Vogue hailed it as the outfit of the year, I knew that this had to be one of the outfits of the year in our season 3 Club Grace subscription. So we are very blessed that we have been able to bring this outfit to life. Again, Grace Marie Fitzpatrick, when Robert Tonner and I were bringing her to life and thinking about her and her makeup and what we wanted her to look like, some people are just extremely kind and say that I sort of look like her, but that was not at all what we were trying to do when we were putting her together and coming up with the concepts. We sent exact photos of the Princess of Wales face and her makeup and her eyebrows and her luscious hair and exactly her. And that is what Grace is. She is timeless, she is elegant, and her style is just that. So this is fun. You can receive a couple more printables that are also available that Diana made, but all of these ones are coming inside your box. And then of course you have your bracelet and your earrings that are packaged just like that. We have, these are my favorite kind of stickers that we do. There are glitter stickers. They're very special. This glittery sticker has Grace dancing in her castle dress and her Shamrock Shimmer dress. So you are going to receive that. We also have a pair of earrings for you, so you can get in the mood on St. Patrick's Day and wear these earrings, or you can use them for a craft project, or if you want to get really crazy, put them on Grace. She'll just have very, very, very large earrings. Now, the keychains are a keepsake for the Grace Marie Fitzpatrick subscription. I am so excited about these. I got custom keychains made. Hopefully you can sort of see them on my finger, but they are large and they are four-leaf clovers. And they are engraved with Fitzpatrick. And then on the chain right here, on the little loop, it says Club Grace 2024. So you are going to receive either a gold or silver keychain. I had these specially made several months ago, and I'm thrilled with them. As soon as we get done with this video, I'm gonna put one on my keychain. You can never have enough keychains, and this, I really love things that are tangible and nice keepsakes from our time together over the last 3 years. Can you believe it? This is our third year. We're gonna be done in June for season 3. That's so crazy to me, but these are beautiful, so you're gonna like that. Now, this is something I know you're gonna love because it's really gonna get you in the spirit. Hopefully you can see, and we'll show it a little bit later in when we talk with Christopher, but look at this beautiful decoration for St. Patrick's Day that is around our table. On each one of these images, on these beautifully printed cards, are Victorian greeting cards for St. Patrick's Day. So the images on them are Victorian children and young adults that are saying St. Patrick's Day greetings. These are antique images, and you are going to receive all of them in this pack right here, along with the ribbon to string it and a needle. You're going to get all of this. So you can use these and put up the banner in your house or in your doll room or whatever you'd like to do. Cut them up and use them for scrapbooking. Give them away, whatever you feel called to do with these. But this is great. This is beautiful. So I'm excited to see what you can do with those. So that's going to be in your box as well. Now, our pattern of the month, of course, is from Tamara Casey of Designs by Jude, who has just been doing such wonderful work. Last month, we enjoyed her The Baker's Dozen for our Sock Hop Sweet Shop theme, and now she made us something totally perfect for our theme of the month. Come on in, Tamara Casey.
Hey, Club Grace family. I'm happy to be back to give you the March pattern reveal. I've shared with you in former videos that I'm often inspired by fabric as I'm coming up with new designs. However, I do have to admit that this month was a little bit of a stumper. Since Rachel has glamour covered with this month's theme, I thought I'd take it in a little bit different direction. The inspiration actually came from something I recently picked up at a doll auction. In one of the lots that I was able to successfully purchase, I found nestled at the very bottom of the box, this fabulous violin. Knowing that Grace's adventure to Ireland would be full of fun activities, I thought one of those stops might be a local Renaissance fair. The Celtic Charm pattern includes an off-the-shoulder floor-length gown with billowy sleeves and an overdress that's fully lined and features eyelet lace-up at the front. Fortunately for Grace, the Renaissance Fair is fully interactive, and her good friend encouraged her to bring her violin. You can see her here as one of the strolling minstrels. I hope you all enjoy the Celtic Charm pattern. Make sure to top that outfit off with a beautiful floral crown, and I can't wait to see what you make.
Thank you so much, Tamara. You never cease to amaze us. I love everything that you do. I've never seen a pattern come from you that I'm like, I don't like that. I like them all. They're always wonderful. So, Tamara, thank you so much for your hard work and making it super fun every month for our members to really get into the spirit worldwide. It's just such a blessing to have you. Tamara Casey right now is doing her March Madness sale. So she's got all kinds of fun things on her website. Make sure to check them out. And we'll see Tamara again next month for our pattern next month. So there's a lot. There's a lot to be excited about and a lot to do with the Grace subscription. There's one more thing in your box that I actually don't have. They have just been shipped, but they are coming fresh from a bakery, a special artisan bakery. And we have some beautiful cookies. I am going to put some examples on the screen of the cookies that I ordered. You're going to receive random cookies, but they are all handmade and decorated, and they're just beautiful. They are sugar cookies from one of my favorite bakeries that I have used before from our subscription. And they always ask, is this because I place large orders, hundreds of cookies, and they know me. I'm like, yep, it's the doll lady. Yep, I'm putting these inside subscription boxes for doll collectors, and they always get a kick out of that. So we have some exciting things planned with them for later this year too that I'm just thrilled about. So we're going to bring in our wonderful stylist, Christopher, and he is going to talk about our fashion, and we're going to get his take. Come on in, Christopher. Hi, Christopher.
Hello.
Happy St. Patrick's Day almost.
Happy St. Patrick's Day almost.
How much fun did you have photographing these dolls?
Actually, quite a bit. I always enjoy that part of my job and have continued to do so more and more as time has gone on. But I love photographing this Grace. I stand by this. I think this is the prettiest that she's ever looked. And although I sometimes enjoy the easier task of styling and photographing wigged dolls that have already come with maybe a set, or they're, you know, prepared to be photographed in some way, I also really enjoy the preparation of a rooted doll, and these dresses are so pretty. So the combination of those things made this very, very fun. Sometimes I get to just like sit and do photography for like hours on end, and with this particular project, I found that to be very satisfying. It's a beautiful dress on a beautiful doll with beautiful hair. Like, I can't think of any part of that to complain about. So it's been very fun. I love this dress, you guys. I think the way it sits on her is so pretty. I love the texture. And again, we still have some of these gift with purchase little green velvet bows that will be sort of trickling out as this box gets to you. So you may be one of the lucky people that gets one this round. And it's got like a comb, so it's really ideal for hairstyling, but it also clips onto the, you know, collar of a shirt or a dress, much like this one, very nicely. I love the ruffle around the sleeve, and at the hem on the bottom. It's very, very, very pretty. It's satiny, so the way that it catches light is reflective without quite being like, I don't know, metallic. It's a flat color, but it's very reflective. It's got a really great glossy quality that, if you are, you know, interested in doll photography, makes it really exciting to photograph, because it will also reflect different lights differently. Have fun with this one. I would recommend steaming or pressing. In this instance, I would say if you have a steamer, break it out. You can just give it a quick puff, because it doesn't really need anything super intensive, but I think everything always benefits from that. If that's at your disposal, exercise it. It's gorgeous. I think I have very little, if any, connection to the holiday itself, but I love that we unanimously have decided that it's a necessary holiday to celebrate at large. I think green is so evocative of spring, right? So obviously, like, you think of foliage and new growth and plants and sprouts and whatever. But I think it's such a perfect holiday to celebrate closing out of winter. So even if you're not Irish, which I think I have, I don't know, I should do like a, you know, who are your, you know, ancestry.com. I should do like a search. I don't know nothing, but I think there's a sliver of Irish somewhere in my lineage. Anyway, I don't feel any connection to it personally, really. It's never meant something super profound in my life, but I love that I can still celebrate what feels like the return of spring just through the color green. So we've been playing with lots of green for this season and putting up shamrocks and Easter eggs and what have you. It's a very natural segue into that, and it doesn't compromise glamour or beauty either. Like, I think so often this is one of many holidays that can be sort of cheapened by the way that you know, partake in the holiday, even if it's just, you know, stringing up a banner and having some beer. I think although satisfactory, it can be more glamorous than it often is. And this, I think, is a great way to do that. Showing you lots of different ways to pair the bracelet with the earring, with the bow, with the shoes. I think this is a really great example of how to use accessories in a more understated way rather than something much louder. It's very elegant. It's very chic. So I really enjoy this one. It does zip up the back, which is very nice. Those ruffles, I think, really do a lot for this dress. This particular example, the blonde, I think with the shoulders and the hair, feels very like boss lady of the 80s. You know, she's the CEO of something, and she's excited to like run this conference, you know, into the ground. It's a fun one. This is a very fun, empowered dress, I think.
So if you were gonna mix and match, there's not a ton that can be done, I don't think, but what are two things that you would do to give it a different look?
Well, I think the bow is a great way to go. So if you don't have this one, there are others that we've issued for a long time. And like always, I think having an anchor point, if your accessory color ties to something else, then I think it's successful. If you have a white bow, or maybe you want to play with like indigo, I think would be really pretty. You could do shades of blue and then have a matching blue shoe, because certain colors paired together when they're next to each other can sometimes bring out a different hue than you would see when they're separate from each other. This has an almost, I mean, emerald as a color has almost a blue base. If you were to pair other, you know, navy, indigo, shades of blue accessories with this, you might see it really translate as a different color. So that'd be very fun. Any of those other bows, pair with the bows, but also wearing it different ways, I think, is really successful. I think this is sort of like a instance to take, you know, lessons away from Coco Chanel. You know, take one accessory off before leaving the house. This is sort of that dress for me, and I know that's like blasphemous coming from me because I love accessorizing so much, but it's so sleek and so classy as it is. I think the way to accessorize with this is playing with the strengths already at your disposal with your dolls, right? I think the way that this appears on three different shades of hair with different makeup, paint, and accessories that come with your doll, you know, manicure, pedicure, what have you, that's a great way to play with accessories. So if you are putting this on a doll with red lips, consider making maybe one statement of a red accessory, you know, what have you. It is actually a very versatile dress, but I just think it stands so strongly by itself. It doesn't necessarily need to be super heavily supplemented. So, fresh out of the box, you get a complete outfit. You're getting earrings and a bracelet and a dress and shoes. That scratches the itch for me. You're getting the whole thing all together. So enjoy that, and again, we have very few but other green accessories for Grace, so go toy with those. I mean, if you've been a subscriber or a collector for any amount of time, you've got a really good selection of things to pair with this. I encourage you to go be courageous and brave and try something that spooks you and you wouldn't try ordinarily otherwise. And take solace in the fact that this is not on you, right? If you don't feel courageous and brave to play with your own fashion in a sort of like experimental way, that's fine. You have the dolls to do it with. So use that instead. She won't voice her opinions to you. You can, try something that even maybe doesn't succeed and try that again. That's half of the job, right? I really enjoy this, and green is one of my favorite colors. I'm not a huge fan of cool tones generally. I've said 100 times, I don't care about blue. I don't care about, a really cool tone pink is not my favorite. I want everything to be like warm and cozy, and I love green. I think that's the perfect balance color. You actually sort of get the best of both worlds with green. I don't know, lean into it and maybe have a beer and enjoy unboxing this all at the same time.
Thank you so much, Christopher. This was a blast.
Thank
you. See you soon. Bye. Thank you so much, Christopher. It's always such a delight to hear what you think about the fashion and all the wonderful things that you do for our subscription and getting the dolls to look so incredibly beautiful. There are no add-ons for the month, so that is a welcome relief for a lot of you, I know, and also probably a disappointment for some of you too, because we love to buy stuff and buying doll things is really fun. But for this month, it is complete, and we are blessed to have so many wonderful things coming in this box. We have 3 more months of the Grace subscription, and get ready, folks, because we are going on so many more adventures. But for this month, we can add another stunning, I'm going to use the word iconic here because Vogue said it was the outfit of the decade, so I think I can do that. Iconic outfit for the Grace Marie Fitzpatrick wardrobe. I literally cannot wait to see this brought back at Christmas time with a Christmas bow and with Christmas accessories. It's just going to be lovely. So we hope you enjoy it to the fullest. We have a couple of extra boxes, I think around 25, that are in the boutique. If you're not a part of the subscription and you'd like to snag one, get it in the Grace boutique right now. And then, of course, when you receive your box, we have 3 different messages that are on the bottom of the boxes. So you might get the same message that you got, but you might get a new one. When you receive your box, look at the message on the bottom. We put special messages just for you. So thank you so much to everybody involved in our subscriptions, and we will see you on the next one. Bye.